welcome to our concert. We are very, very glad that you came. It means a lot to us as musicians here on the stage to have your support and to participate with us this evening. Our concert this evening is actually a very formal rehearsal. This Saturday morning, we have been invited to participate in the state concert festival, which will be at Corona High School, and we perform at 8:45 a.m. And tonight, we need to get kind of loose ends tied up, and so we've chosen to perform the pieces, plus a couple of extra ones that we're going to perform Saturday. Our first piece by Aaron Copland, who is a contemporary American composer, one of the most famous American composers, was originally written for a high school orchestra in New York City in 1938. The conductor of this high school orchestra asked Mr. Copland to write something that was peppy and that could show off all the different sections of the orchestra and something that he felt high school students would like. And so this is the result of that commission for New York City High School Orchestra and Outdoor Overture.
Thank you.
Eric has been principal cellist of the Allstate Orchestra, and if he weren't my son, I certainly would have featured him on the concert, and so please bear with me. I have some motherly pride here on the next number.
Just a short note, Haydn lived at the end of the 1700s, and so you would expect
you know, we just returned from an absolutely fabulous tour of the Los Angeles area this last weekend. It has become a tradition. Hey guys, it has become a tradition for us to kind of auction off things that were left on the bus. And so tonight, we have one music stand. We have one camera, and I'd love to claim this if nobody does. We have a pair of whatever these are called. We have someone's medication. We have a nice shirt. Moms, if you recognize any. One white, relatively clean sock. A wonderful black scarf that Zara Neale Hurston would have used. You tell us, know what I mean. Half of a stand. And one bluish sock. Clean. We couldn't have had nearly the wonderful time that we did if we hadn't had such terrific chaperones along on the tour. And I'd like to recognize them at this time. Bonnie Thomas, stand up. Where are you? Jackie and Kendall Johnson. You see what tours do, they split families. And Carla Nancy Siebert. They were terrific. Tours, if you've never been on one with a group like this, the chaperones average about 3 hours of sleep every night if it's a good, quiet night. And it probably, we've decided, will take us till summertime probably to recover. But it's worth it because the things that we saw, the Phantom of the Opera, the Los Angeles Philharmonic, the Huntington Art Museum, the places that we played, even Magic Mountain, it was terrific. We had a wonderful time. And I thank you for your support and for financing that trip. It was worth your money. It was great. I have a little present for the chaperone, so if you please come up here right afterward. Okay. Our last number, one that we're going to do this Saturday, the Fantasia on a Theme by Thomas Tallis by Vaughan Williams, which seems like an awful mouthful to say for a title, is written for a double string orchestra plus soloists, a string quartet of soloists. Usually you get to see the soloists at the end of a piece. I'm going to introduce you to them at the beginning so you'll kind of get a feel how this is going to go. Can we have the second orchestra stand up? Thank you. Can we have the string quartet stand up? And then out of the string quartet, Nick Berger on the viola and Eric Thomas on the violin will have extended solos. Thank you. Just a little background about this piece might make you understand it and enjoy it more. Vaughan Williams, an English composer, was very much into old English folk tunes and English music. He researched them extensively, and he found some pieces written by Thomas Tallis, who lived in the 1500s, they're not quite sure, but around that period of time. And he set them to music for this orchestration. It's the kind of music that we had a guest conductor 2 weeks ago from ASU, Dr. Smith, and he said this is the epitome of string playing. And it really is a credit to these students that we can even attempt to do this. It's gorgeous. It is just gorgeous. You need to sit back and think of old cathedrals and stained glass windows and dust coming through this. I mean, the sunlight coming through the windows and little particles of dust rising up and candles in sconces and things of that nature. It's very long. It's about 17 or 18 minutes long. I'm warning you now, so get very comfortable in your chairs. Please do not snore because there are some very quiet parts. But it is, I hope you enjoy it. It's incredibly beautiful.